Hello, welcome back. I'm Ayat.
And I'm Iman.
And today, Iman will tell you the tip for today, and at the end, I will tell you a funny joke.
So, let's begin. Okay, so today's tip is going to be about how what you should say or what you should do around your food. So, for example, Sally's brother, Bob, and her mom and dad are all eating dinner together. But the mom asks if Bob did his homework. But Bob says, yes, I did my homework. But he didn't. So then Sally's like, no, you didn't. You didn't do your homework. You're lying. And then Bob and Sally start to fight. Now, when they angrily started to eat their food, the next day, Sally's stomach was very in pain. But and Bob, he got a bruise on his pinky toe. And you know, pinky toes really hurt when they're in pain, right? So he stubbed it and got a bruise. So now their dad searched up Sally's stomach was it feeling good?
Yeah.
he searched up why that happened, and then he saw that there's someone named Usaramoto. He actually is a scientist who he got a whole bunch of people by a river, and they all said this good stuff like you're the best water. Or they all were being kind to each other. And then he collected some water and looked at it under a microscope. I mean, you know, whatever it's called, microscope. And what he saw was that it turned into like a nice crystal or a nice snowflake. Very beautiful. But then he got people to say to the water, you're stinky, you don't taste good. This doesn't taste good. And then they're all being mean to each other. Then he tested it again. But this time, when he checked through the microscope, he saw that it all, instead of a snowflake, it was something else. It was all like, ice. Yeah, it was all, it was
broken up and it looked terrible, yeah.
Yes, how do you know?
Because, remember?
Okay, anyways, so now it kind of affected the water. So let's say you drank the water after that, and all the ice and like the ugliness went inside your body. So that probably would ruin like germs. Germs don't look good, right? The same thing with the water. Germs make you unhealthy. So water would probably hurt your stomach or stuff like that. So now the dad taught them and told them all of the stories that he saw. So then, the next night, Bob and Sally, they were speaking the truth and they were being very good. So, I have a little lesson. That was my little story, if you liked it. So the lesson basically is that you should be nice around your food, or you should not be bad.
Respect
your food, guys.
So, Ayat, you can go with your joke, and if you want to say anything else, you can go ahead.
I don't have to say anything else, but now it's time for my joke. So, my joke is chicken. What is a ghost's favorite snack?
I don't know.
It's burritos. You know the chip. Doritos? It's burritos. The burritos.
What about burrito? What about
burrito? Me.
You know burritos that you go into a wrap?
No, it's not.
Okay.
The chips, but it could also be it. Burritos.
So that's all we have for today. Please like and
subscribe and make sure to like all of our videos and hit the notification bell.
And wait. So, your little thing you should do after. So maybe if you have a microscope, maybe you should try doing Sarimoto's thing he did, like his water test. Maybe you can try doing that with other food. Maybe you can do it when you're eating chicken, or when you're eating salad, or when you're eating juice. You can try doing all that stuff with it. But if you don't have a microscope, that's okay. You can always maybe write down ideas of things that maybe you have of what the snowflake could, the water droplet could do, how it could look like, what things can cause it. And yeah, that's pretty much.
That's all we had for today, guys. Remember, like, subscribe.
And we will see you next time. Bye!